My name is Hubert Rabiel, and I knew Marty Baker was the pastor at this church. And I went online, found out where it was located. I'm on my way down to Cary, North Carolina, and I just wanted a chance to see him. He didn't realize I was coming, and I haven't seen him since 1976, but he led me to the Lord. We met as freshmen in high school. We were both left-handed, and I think that's what drew us to each other. On a baseball team, there's not many players left-handed, so we would warm up together, travel on the school bus together. We developed a friendship, and that was first and foremost to me with Marty. I knew he was a Christian, but at that time I was not. And he always found effective ways to witness that were never threatening to me. I never felt like he was better than me because he was a Christian. And he never made me feel like I was not worthy because I was not a Christian. So his friendship was always the most important part of our relationship. He was just easy to talk to, and I just had a good time on the school bus. Sometimes you travel an hour and a half, 2 hours. We had fun, but basically horse playing on the bus, smashing each other's lunches. You know, we'd brown bag it to the baseball game. We just had a good time in high school. I mean, you just talked about what you did in school, what your plans were for the future, and he knew at that time he was going to be a pastor. And at that time, I thought I was going to be a doctor, but God had other plans for me. Yeah, in high school, my dad was retired Navy, and he started working at a uniform and towel company. So we moved back to El Centro, where my grandparents were, and that's where I started high school. So home life, we didn't go to church. Now, I always knew my parents loved me. They knew how to spank me when I got out of hand growing up. But in high school, church wasn't a part of our daily life. Well, I always trusted my parents, and I never felt like I had a need for Jesus because I had the security of mom and dad. I could go home and there they were. And about late in my junior year in high school, I started drinking. And sometimes things would happen. I wouldn't remember what happened the night before. Marty knew that, but he would always still talk to me. But he never attended any of the drinking parties that I would go to. And there was an incident when I was 17. My cousin was 15. I knew I couldn't drive, so I handed him the keys to my car. And he actually drove me home to his aunt's house, to his mom's house. I spent the night at my aunt's. And it was at that time I realized I needed to make a change, but I knew Marty had gone on to Azusa Pacific College. I was a hospital corpsman in the Navy. So I woke up the next morning realizing this wasn't the life for me, and I knew I needed to make a change. And I went back up to San Diego, and as God works things out, about 2 weeks later, Marty and I met at a high school football game, not knowing we were going to be there. I knew Marty was a Christian, and he had witnessed to me all 4 years of high school. And there were two specific incidents that I remember. He invited me to a Corey Ten Boom movie, The Hiding Place, and there was an invitation to accept Christ at the end of that movie, and I didn't respond. And then, like I said, we would ride school buses, and if we went up to the San Diego area, we would have to go over mountains. And there was a stretch of road that had a cliff overhang, and he asked me on one of the trips, if this bus were to go over the edge and we were all to die, do I know where eternity would be for me? And I said, well, not really, but at that time, I wasn't interested in it. So when we met at the football game, I knew this was my opportunity. I knew he could lead me to Christ. And at that moment in the front seat of his dad's car, he let me do the talking. I had to admit that I was a sinner. I had to accept Jesus Christ into my heart. And that's what I did. He actually gave me a church to attend in San Diego. I just found out today that Pastor Lind led him to Christ. And that's where I was attending church in San Diego. life since San Diego, I was a hospital corpsman. I really felt like God wanted me in San Diego. I was having a great time at the church. I was growing as a Christian. And Pastor Lind was a chaplain in the Naval Reserve, so we had a lot in common. I was active duty and he was in the reserves. But when the orders came through after I graduated from lab school, the orders said NRMC Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. I didn't want to go. And I told the pastor that, and with his wisdom, he said, you need to go. God has a plan for you. You don't know what that plan is yet, but there is a plan for your life. And when I left, he had given me a list of 10 churches in the Philadelphia area. He didn't know where they were. He didn't know how I would get there. And the second church I contacted was Holmesburg Baptist Church. And the second thing he did when I left, he gave me a hymnal. I can't sing. He knew that. I knew that. But he said, open the hymnal, read the words in some of the hymns, and they will touch your heart. And I was sent out to Philadelphia just before Thanksgiving. So Thanksgiving night, I'm feeling sorry for myself because I was by myself in the barracks. I pulled the hymnal out, and there was a hymn called So Send I You. And it talked about how you're going to leave family, loved ones, and God's going to send you to a place to witness for Him alone. And that's exactly how I felt. So I made a note of that hymn in my diary. And Holmesburg Baptist Church is the second church I attended that Sunday after Thanksgiving. Their call to worship that morning was So Send I You. And I knew at that moment, this is where God wanted me. That's where I met my wife, and the rest, as they say, is history. What I wanted and what God wanted were two totally different things. And when you accept Christ and let Him lead your life, you have to go where you don't want to go. But He will keep you where He wants you. If you want to be a witness for Christ, you have to have non-Christian friends that you can talk to, that they feel comfortable coming to you, because a non-Christian knows who the Christian is. And sometimes the only Bible they can read is you as a Christian. Because of Marty, a lot of my relatives I will see again. My parents accepted Christ late in life. My grandparents accepted Christ late in life. And it was because I became a Christian and could live the Christian life. My relatives could see that, and they eventually came to a saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. So because of Marty, there'll be a good time in heaven. Just keep the faith, and in the words of Jim Valvano, don't give up. Don't ever give up.